Welcome back, friends. Today we are going to see more information about the Markita framework. In the last video we have seen how to mock the object using Markita framework without writing our custom mock object. Okay, if you missed that video, I have given the description, please take a look, and after that watch this video. That will be better. Okay. Here you can see data list service. It's a very simple class. Okay, I have not written any DB part, nothing. It's a very simple class. Using this class, we're going to see how to mock these data list services by testing the save method and the view method. When you look at this data list service, this data list service section from array list. Okay, in this class, I have implemented two methods. One is save method, another one is a view method. The save method, I am adding a data to the array list. Return add data. Whatever string data passed in the save method argument, method parameter, I am adding that value to my list object. The view method is internally calling the get method from the array list. Get of index. Whatever index value you are passing here, for that index, I am returning the respective element. While returning the element, I am converting that to uppercase. That's it. Okay, I'm for these two methods. Now we're going to test these two methods. Now in the test folder, I created another class called product service. I think data list service test. Data list service test. Okay, data list service test. So data list service equal to mock of data list service dot class. I'm mocking my data list service. I don't want to test this real method. Just I want to mock this data list service. Then I want to test. Okay. So here globally I'm mocking that my data list services. Now I want to test the save method. Public void add param test. While saving method, I want to test this scenario. Data list service dot save, I am passing Suresh, then return true. Whenever pass any element, okay, I want to return true. So I am saying they then return true. Actually, when you do this save, right, it never really don't add. It really don't add here. Okay. At runtime, it will create a one mock object of array list, data list service. In the data list service add, then I am saying after adding return to. Okay, so the Markita framework runtime mock object return the true. Okay, when data list service are saved, whenever call save method. So here I need to add save method. Okay, whenever call save method, I want return true. Then I am checking assert equals expected true. data list service dot save, I am passing Suresh. While adding Suresh using save method, I am saying yes, then return true. Now I am checking it's returning true or not here using assert equals. Let's check now. Yeah, test case is passed. In this test case, I am checking only while adding Suresh. If you add any other value, for example, let's say I am adding Joe here. While adding Joe, I then return true, I am saying. But here I am checking data list of service. I am adding Suresh here, saving Suresh here. Okay, but here I am telling to Markita framework, whenever save Joe value, then only return true. But here I am saving the Suresh, right? So this test case get failure. Now see, failed because I am giving the instruction to Markita framework while saving Joe value, then only you have to return true. Otherwise you should not return true. I am saying that. Okay, but here I am adding Suresh, right? That's the reason it is giving the fail. It's failing. Test case is failing. Okay, now it will get passed. Yeah, test case is passed. Now I want to check negative test cases. So from whenever user try to add null value or empty value, I want return false. Okay. Now when data service dot save, while saving a null value, then return false I am saying. So I in the assert equals method I am trying to add a null value. While adding a null value, it returns false because I am giving instruction to the marketer framework, return false while saving a null value. Okay. This is just to get familiarity of marketer framework API. I'm giving these small test cases. Okay. In the next class, we will go to see some advanced level. Okay. Then app param any string test. So in this case, right, in the first test case is what you have done. Whenever add any value, for example, whenever add Joe value, Joe string, then only this test case will pass. If you pass other than Joe, the test case will fail, right? Now I don't want to do that. Any string, whenever save any string, my test case should pass. So that test case I implemented here. Where data list service add any string. There is some static method called any string. Okay, there are a lot of static methods in the marketer framework. Okay, go here. The marketer class, there is a many static method. Okay, all are self-explanatory. Okay, you can go and check all the methods, you can try it out. Okay. Any string, when data list service add any string, if user add any string, then return true. So here I'm adding data list service dot add Suresh. I am saying add Suresh. Even if you add any other value, it will work. Okay. If the test case is passed, anything you can pass here, but must be the type of string value. That's it. That is the use of any string. Add method accepting the string value. I want to generically test. Okay. Whatever string value we try to save in using data list service, I want to check that scenario. In that case, we can use any string. Okay. Okay. Now, then I want to, this test case is nothing but param with return value. Okay. Now, whenever you add, you can use your save method. I forgot to use my method. So I added ArrayList method directly here. Okay. We can check with save method also here. It will give the same result. Okay. Why is returning failure? Why? Because here I am saying data service list dot add. I am giving the instruction whenever call add method from the data list service, then return true. I am saying, right? But here I am asserting usual data service dot save method. By calling save method, I am asserting whether it's returning true or not. But here I am not giving that instruction. Here I have given add method instruction, right? So we need to change your app. Save. Okay, now this method is param with return value. So whenever view any value that returns some value, right? For example, let's say here I'm saying when data list service dot view 0th index position, while viewing 0th index position, please return this value. I'm saying please return this IT garden value. I'm saying to the marketer framework. In the marketer framework, I'm giving the instruction whenever call view method by passing 0th index, 0th index, that time please return IT garden. Here I am saying assert equals expected IT garden data service list dot get. I am saying here we should not say get because we are here given the instruction for view, right? So we need to give view. So whenever call this method, whenever call this view method, according to this instruction, this return IT garden. This return view return IT garden. That IT garden verifying with my expected value IT garden. So this test case must pass. Whatever instruction you have given here, the same according to that instruction we have to implement, we have to assert here. Okay, you have to assert here. Otherwise, test case will fail. For example, let's say I'll pass IT garden 1. View while calling view method by passing 0th index, then return IT garden 1. I am saying, okay, so here I am calling view method by passing 0th index, but I am expecting the value IT garden, but this view return IT garden 1 because here I given that instruction. So this test case get failed. It's failed, right? So I'll change back to 1. Say IT garden. Similarly, here I am by here while invoking view method by passing 0th index, then only return IT garden. I am saying. So here you have to use 0th index only. If I pass any other index, it will fail. So it's failed, right? Because I am passing wrong index. Okay, how to use generic index? I can pass any index right here. I want to check how to do that. That is this example here. When data list service view any int, while passing any int, then return IT garden. Whatever index you are passing, while passing any index, please return IT garden. I am saying to the marketer framework. Here assert equals IT garden index 0 I am passing, index get I am passing. Yeah, so index 1 I am passing, right? Now this case must fail. Why it should must fail? I am passing still any int. Let's see. It's failing or not. Yeah, it's failed because here the marketer framework I am giving the instruction while calling view by passing any int, then return IT garden saying. But in the assert equals method, I am expecting IT garden while by invoking get method. By invoking get method. But here I am using view method, right? So we have to change view here. Now test case is passed. Then verify test. Some method does not return any value, right? Just it's invoker. What? By invoking some method, the piece of code get executed inside the function. Now I want to ensure that the particular method is really invoked or not. I want to verify it. So in that case, we can use verify method. You can use verify method. Here, data list service dot add ROM. Data list service dot add money. So two times I am calling this particular add method. While calling this add method, I am adding two different value, ROM and money, right? Now I am verifying it. Verify data list service at least once while calling add method. While calling add method by passing any string, please check its get invoked at least once. In here, we called it two times, right? So it's executed at least once. Definitely it will execute, right? Two times executed, but you are checking at least once. If at least one time executed by passing any string in the add method, then pass it as case, I am saying. Okay. We're going to change the save method. I want to test our own method, okay? I don't want to test our list method. Save. All the places I will save. Okay. Okay, now I'll comment out this section. Now we'll test this. Now test case is passed because we are calling this save method two times, but yet checking at least once. Definitely it executed one time. Now I'll going to comment out this. Now I should get failure. That's failed. Okay, now uncomment this. Now I commented out 51 line. That meaning I'm calling one time save method. Then I'm verifying the save method should execute at least one time by passing any string. And then again verify data list service dot times. The times method you can pass number of execution time, how many times executed particular method. Here we are checking save method, right? Save method. Here I'm checking from the data list service, the save method should execute two times. If execute two times by passing any string, that time you pass this test case, I'm saying. Let's see what's happening now. You should failure, actually. This part failure. This should pass, this should failure. Yeah. Wanted two times, but it was one time. It's clearly saying, right? I'm expecting two times should execute the same method, but it executed only one time because I commented out this section, right? So the same method called only one time. Now we should pass because I am calling two times. Now it's called because two times I'm calling here, so I'm verifying the save method invoking two times by passing any string. Now final check is never. I am going to pass ROM here. Let's see what's happening. My expectation is the 54th line should get failure. Yeah, it's failed, right? The reason is here I am saying data list never save of ROM. I am saying the meaning of this line is whenever calling save method, if ROM is not added, then this test case should pass. But I adding here ROM is already added so that Markito framework fail these test cases. Here I'm checking only if ROM is not added by passing save method, then only this test case should pass. Never mean that is the meaning of never. Now I'll going to change some other value which are not added in the data list service. The data according to this test cases data list service I'm adding ROM and money. I never added Suresh, right? So this test case should pass now. Okay, now this is passed because Suresh is never added, right? Now argument capture test. What is argument capture test? Whenever I add any argument to the method, I want to make sure that argument is passed, that particular argument value is passed. That is the use of argument capture. Data list service dot add Suresh argument capture. Argument capture dot for class string. Whenever add string type value in my add method of, I'll change save method here. I don't want to use add method. Whenever pass string value while calling save method, I want to check that string value. I want to check that string value, expected value. It is correct. I want to pass this test case. That's it. See here, argument capture, argument capture, define the argument, argument capture, string, argument capture type is string data. Then verify data list service, verify data list service dot save. While saving, while calling save method, I am passing argument dot capture. While saving, I am capturing the particular argument value, here. Then using assert request, I am passing this expected value, then argument capture dot get value. This argument capture return whatever value we are passing here. Then this return Suresh, I am checking that Suresh value with expected Suresh. So this test case is passed. Through this way we can verify that, make sure that you are passing current argument in your test cases. Let me check now. Okay. Now what will happen if passing multiple arguments? I want to check multiple arguments. That also possible. This is the example of multiple arguments. A data list service dot add Joe, data list service dot add Peter. Two value I'm adding here. I want to capture these two argument value. The same syntax you have to follow, argument capture, argument capture, argument capture for class of string dot class. I want to capture string type argument from the add method. Verify data list times of 2, because I am calling it 2 times, right? That is the reason I am saying times of 2. While invoking 2 time of add method, capture that argument here. So I am adding add Joe, add Peter 2 times. Here I am giving the instruction to Markdown framework, verify data list service. While calling add method 2 times, that 2 times you have captured that argument which I am passing here. So here I given the instruction. After that, argument dot get values, I am saying argument capture dot get values. What will happen here? Get values return all the argument data which passed the add method. Here 2 times I am calling the add method. So this get value return Joe and Peter as a list object. Now this all values contain Joe and Peter, right? So here I am asserting that value here. Assert equals Joe get of 0, assert equals Peter get of 1. Through this way we can capture multiple argument values. So through these examples we come to know that we learned some more information about the Markdown framework. The final method is spy. What is use of spy? I will continue with spy in next video. Until then, bye bye from Suresh. If you have any question, please comment me, definitely I will reply back. Okay. Please take this source code from the GitHub. I will give the link in the video description. You can download this entire project. Okay. Okay guys, bye bye from Suresh. We'll see in the next video session. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.